Good morning, everyone. Today, we are going to discuss about Anglo-Saxon model of corporate governance. Anglo-Saxon model. This model is also known as Anglo-American model. It is used as corporate governance in USA, UK, Canada, Australia, and some Commonwealth countries. Anglo-Saxon model of corporate governance is a system of supervision and control over the corporation functioning of above mentioned countries. The main feature of this model is to try on the capital market or rely on the capital market as the place of control over the corporation. The shareholders appoint directors who in turn appoint the managers to manage the business. Thus, there is a separation of ownership and control. And now let us know what is Anglo-Saxon model. The board usually consists of executive directors and few independent directors, and they are elected by the shareholders who have voting right to elect the board of directors. The board often has limited ownership stakes in the company. Moreover, a single individual holds both the position of CEO and chairman of the board. There will be auditors in the board. There will be 15 in number. And this model relies on effective communication between shareholders, board, and management, with all important decisions taken after getting approval by shareholders, and it will be by voting. And the main feature of the model is to rely on the capital market as the place of control over the corporation. Supervision is exercised mostly by investors who express their favors or disapproval for the actions of management by buying and selling shares of the company and voting during the general meeting of the shareholders. In this model, the management, the organization shall not subject to the strict control within the organization due to the high liquidity of the market. The relationship between the management and the shareholders are short-lived and official. Anglo-Saxon model implies a strong emphasis on the results achieved by the company and the security of their shareholders. Less importance is put on the long-term business development. And next, let us see the features of Anglo-Saxon model. The ownership of the company is more or less equally divided between individuals and shareholders and institutional shareholders. Directors are rarely independent of management. Companies are typically run by professional managers who have negligible ownership stake. There is fairly clear separation of ownership and management. Most institutional investors are reluctant activists. They view themselves as portfolio investors interested in investing in the broadly diversified portfolio of liquid securities. It is not satisfied within the company's performance. They simply sell the securities in the market and quit. The disclosure norms are comprehensive. The rules against insider trade tight penalties for price manipulation. They also discourage large investors from taking an active role in corporate governance. And some added to the features are: the ownership of shares is distributed. Banks only slightly engage in the operation of the company. Market is an active mechanism of control over the corporation. And internal supervisory authority is board of directors. And the measure of success is the share price and dividend. Capital market are characterized by high transparency. The biggest role of assigned implementation of the goals and objectives of shareholders, and growing strength of concentrated share ownership, particularly pension funds and institutional investors. And the other point is capital is raised on large and liquid capital market. And next, we are moving on to the key players in Anglo-Saxon model. As we discussed earlier, they are three: management, shareholders and board of directors. And this is the small model of Anglo-Saxon model. And as we know, the shareholders who have voting right and the owners of the company, who are the owners of the company, elect the board of directors, and the board of directors appoint and control the officers and managers who should work below them, and the officers and managers who has the power of leadership and internal control of operating activities of the company. And the same officers and managers are accountable to the board of directors to report their performance, and the company is liable to report their working, their activities, their profits to the stakeholders who are employees, suppliers, creditors, communities and government. And that's a short about Anglo-Saxon model, and from that I think you all understood what is Anglo-Saxon model. Thank you.